Wild Wings. You have to be here.
The 2007 Chevy Impala gets an EPA estimated 31 miles per gallon highway, and it's backed by the GM 100,000 mile warranty. Learn more. Go to Yahoo and click Autos. Qualified lessees can get a low mileage lease on this 07 Impala LT for around $199 a month. Residency restrictions apply. Call for details. See your local Chevy dealer or visit ChevyLocalDealer.com.
FSN South congratulates Justin Williams, 2000.
The following is an exclusive presentation of Lincoln Financial Sports, a member of Lincoln Financial Group. Stegman Coliseum on the Georgia campus in Athens, the site of tonight's big SEC Eastern Division matchup. And at 5:30 this afternoon, the students lined up outside getting geared up for tonight's game. And inside the Coliseum, they're ready to make some noise tonight as three-point threat Levi Stooks and the Georgia Bulldogs host inside force Randolph Morris and the Kentucky Wildcats. From Stegman Coliseum in Athens, Georgia, the all-tail SEC game of the week, matching the Kentucky Wildcats and the Bulldogs of Georgia. Hello, everyone, and welcome to Athens. I'm Tom Hammond, ready for this Eastern Division matchup. Two teams that had frustrating losses over the weekend. Georgia on a controversial last-second shot against Alabama after having a big lead, and Kentucky falling to Vanderbilt for only the second time ever at Rupp Arena. Larry Connie's here for the color commentary. Larry, that just adds a little bit of spice to what is really an important Eastern Division matchup.
Well, it is. You know, when we began the season, everybody knew Florida was going to be one of the contenders in the East. We just didn't know who else was going to be chasing them. If you're going to ask me about the West, don't. I have no clue. Anybody who comes over there with 9 wins may be in position to win it.
All right, for tonight, what about our Pontiac keys to the game?
Well, the keys to the game for Kentucky, obviously, they've got to protect the basketball. This Georgia defense is very, very good on the perimeter. For the Bulldogs, they have one of the leading three-point shooting teams in the conference. 5 guys, count them, 5 shooting 37% or better from beyond that three-point stripe.
And, of course, Vanderbilt hit 11 threes in beating Kentucky this past Saturday. Kentucky, though, has whipped the Bulldogs 5 straight times. But the Dogs think this is their night. Back for the opening tip in a moment.
They call me the bus driver kid because I'm about to take you to school.
Vega!
Oh! Oh! Oh!
Man, I sent it to everybody.
Hey.
What are you guys looking at?
Nothing.
Catch My Circle Mania. Text HOOPS to 84353 for a chance to win 100,000 bucks.
Well, unless one of you boys can beat a straight flush, then the pot is mine. No? Ooh, same time next week, suckers.
Going to extremes to make ends meet?
Nice, Timmy.
Try spending less on car insurance.
You can keep that.
1-800-SAFE-AUTO. Minimum coverage for minimum budgets.
Will you take plastic?
What's an emergency that makes you feel so good? B vitamins for that afternoon boost. Emergency. Feel the good.
In a world where portions are out of control, Dexatrim Max helps you stay in control safely.
It curbs my appetite so I can say enough.
It kickstarts my metabolism so I have energy to work out.
Dexatrim Max. Maximum health in a maxed out world.
TV.
The Alltel SEC Game of the Week is being brought to you by Alltel, by Ruby Tuesday, by Geico, by Chevrolet, and by Bell Sound.
Welcome back to Georgia. The Kentucky Wildcats 15-4, 4-1 in the SEC. The Georgia Bulldogs 11-6, 3-2 in conference play. The Wildcats will start this way with Bradley Jasper Perry, who had 13 points against Vanderbilt on Saturday, and Randolph Morris, who had a subpar game but has had 7 double-doubles so far this season. And Joe Crawford, averaging 18 points a game in SEC contests since the league play started, but a poor shooting afternoon in the loss to Vanderbilt at Rupp Arena this past Saturday. And the Georgia starting lineup with Gaines, Stukes, Brown, and Bliss. Stukes is the leading three-point shooter in the Southeastern Conference. And, of course, you see Mike Mercer highlighted. He has been the Dogs' leading scorer all season long. He's averaging over 15 points a game for the Georgia Bulldogs. And there's Tubby Smith surrounded by his team. Tubby, of course, spent a couple of productive seasons here as the coach at the University of Georgia, now in his 10th season in Lexington. And while Tubby spent some time in Athens, Dennis Felton spent some time in Kentucky. Dennis Felton's in his fourth year as the Georgia coach, but prior to that was the coach at Western Kentucky University in Bowling Green. So, Larry, it is a very important game, and Kentucky losing at home. Road wins are so hard to come by in the SEC this season that it's doubly damaging when you lose a game at home.
Well, the difficulty for Kentucky was the fact that they lost to Vanderbilt, and it's the second time in 2 years that they've lost to them in Rupp Arena. And this is a team that I think desperately needs a confidence win right now. For the Bulldogs, it's a little bit different story. I mean, they're still upset about that loss that they had over in Tuscaloosa on Saturday. I think Dennis Felton felt like after they got out to that 19-point lead, they were well on their way to a victory, a good road victory against a ranked club. But it was not to be, as Steele made a big basket at the end there. And as you said, a very controversial one.
Yeah, most people thought he had walked before he made that shot. So about ready to go in Athens. This jump ball is brought to you by Alltel Wireless. Take the MyCircle head-to-head challenge at alltelcircle.com and see how the competition stacks up against MyCircle. And the game underway as the Bulldogs control.
Kentucky opens up in a man-to-man defense. Bulldogs will attack. As I indicated, a great three-point shooting team, this Georgia Bulldog squad. Probably just what Kentucky does not need to see after what they witnessed on Saturday.
Tony Green, Rick Crawford, Anthony Jordan are the officials for tonight's game.
Kentucky's defense has been stellar this year. They have done an awfully good job, at least on scoring defense and field goal percentage defense.
Bliss can't get a shot off over Morris, and then Georgia turns it over with 4 on the shot clock. A good start defensively for the Wildcats.
One of the things that Dennis Felton has harped about with this club is their turnovers. They average 17 a game, which is really much, much too much for them. And they're a good high-scoring club. They like to go up and down. They're in the man-to-man defense.
They average 80 points, 80 and a half points a game, which is third in the SEC. Kentucky, by contrast, 72. They're 10th.
Good screen there for Jasper. He decided not to use it.
And Bliss deflects out of bounds on the entry pass to Randolph Morris. Vanderbilt did a wonderful job Saturday of fronting Morris and having a player to slough over from behind to prevent the entry pass to keep him bottled up all afternoon.
And the way he's been playing this year, they depend on him so much on the offense.
They expect Georgia to be very physical. Bobby Perry missing a three and rebounded by Mercer. Mercer with a pass to Brown for the throwdown.
Great acquisition there, Takeus Brown for Georgia. Dennis Felton recognized he had a gap in this inside play. He went out and got a big timer.
And here's a 5-second call against the freshman Derek Jasper. Here's that.
Takeus Brown is so quick. Watch Mercer with the basketball right here. That is an on-the-move, one-handed pass. Brown with great hands. Out of the junior college ranks. Dennis Felton recognizing he needed to fill something down there, and he went out and got a truly good post player.
Turnovers even at one apiece. Browns couldn't get away. Got it to Bliss. Now Mercer.
Good defense by Kentucky.
Deflecting the shot, and Morris takes it down for the Wildcats. Look at the quick hands of Levi Stoops deflecting the ball. Couldn't quite get it before it went out of bounds, but no pass is safe.
Well, the question I've got is, why is Morris throwing the ball to Jasper with Stoops trailing him the way he was? Just stop and hold the ball and let him come to him and get the ball.
Stoops is sixth in the SEC in steals. His teammate, Cindy Gaines, is first.
That's what I said, they've got to protect the ball tonight, because this club can, they will just pilfer your pocket.
There's Gaines guarding Jasper. The freshman figures to see him right in his face all night. Crawford, open three.
I tell you what, that's a good sign. When he gets off of Snide and starts hitting right from the beginning, Kentucky seems to play much better. Crawford with a good start.
So Crawford hits his first shot. Wildcats have their first lead.
And a 1-4 alignment is set for Georgia. Good motion offense. They move this ball very well.
Bliss fumbled it away. Picked up though by Brown. Georgia retains possession with five to shoot. Quick hands by Bradley got it away. And then just as the shot clock was ticking down, Stoops nails the jump shot.
Georgia fortunate on that possession. They came up with two loose balls on the floor and came back and got a bucket out of that.
Deflected out by Mercer. Here's the first substitution of the game. It's Sheree Thomas, who replaces Bobby Perry. Thomas had 12 points off the Kentucky bench against Vanderbilt Saturday.
Tom, one of the things that Dennis Felton does well with this Georgia basketball team, he really does a good job of on-the-ball defense and first pass away from the ball on the wings. Very tough to make a pass from the point to the wings against this Georgia club.
Rashad Singleton on for Georgia, 7-foot sophomore from Campbellton, Florida, has started 10 times for Dennis Felton this season. Averages 4 points, 3 boards a game.
Singleton doing a nice job of fronting Morris underneath.
He has the kind of body that can muscle Randolph Morris. Shot clock under 10. Kentucky with a lot of dribbling out front, which is usually not a good sign for the Cats.
And Morris is going to pick up an offensive foul here.
Morris trying to get position underneath is called for his first personal foul. That's the first against the Wildcats. Georgia has not committed a foul. And we're 3.5 minutes into the game from Athens. Dogs with the ball up one.
Good feeling that these are two boxers kind of feeling each other out a little bit.
Nobody's landed a haymaker yet, but there will be some before the night's over. Good pass. Singleton didn't quite get his balance, but got the rebound. Misses again. Mercer put it home.
Tell you, Mike Mercer, their leading scorer, has been terrific this year, particularly on those types of shots. Seems to be where the ball is.
Skip pass to Jasper, comes to Crawford, three-pointer good. Joe Crawford has both three-pointers, all six Kentucky points.
Good job of retreating that time by Kentucky to get back and not allow Georgia to set up a quick break.
Yep, turn Gaines away as he made a move inside. Now Mercer with a crossover. Stoops checked by Bradley. Bob inside, good weak side help. And Brown is forced to call a timeout to prevent the turnover. They were fronting him, and then Morris came from the backside to help out. And a timeout, Georgia, in a tie game at 6.
High-definition widescreen TVs than just about anybody else in America. It's the sign of a great deal. Aaron's has the widescreen and LCD flat panel TVs that everybody wants, all at the price everybody wants, the guaranteed lowest price. Aaron's also sells brand new, brand name furniture, appliances, and computers at the guaranteed lowest price. No credit check and the most flexible payment plans. So picture yourself getting your next TV at Aaron's. Do the math. Nobody beats Aaron's.
We've got a crystal story that will rock your world. Well, we got to our local gig and they were closed.
It was like, what? No show.
We called up Crystal. They let us come over there.
Everyone was chowing down on some sweet crystal. It rocked.
It was pure rock and roll with me.
Our crystal concert
was by far
the best gig
we have ever played, ever.
Crystal saves the day.
Crystal rocks.
Crystal rock. Give me my chicks.
Whatever.
Try new saucy chicks. Or don't. It's your call.
All Night Pet Store. Got the idea from Jack. He says you gotta offer your customers anything, anytime.
No sleeping.
A Jack in the Box, that might mean a burger for breakfast or French toast sticks at midnight. For me, it might be a poodle at 2 a.m.
Are you a laundromat?
No. Need a hamster?
Order anything on the menu, anytime. From the guy who wrote the book.
To you in part by Crystal. 6-6 game, Kentucky and Georgia. Kentucky's only gotten three shots. They've hit two of three. Georgia, three of six. Kentucky's turned it over twice. One turnover for Georgia. Dogs got 2 points off the Kentucky miscue. Shot clock ticking down with three to tick, three to shoot. They bail the Bulldogs out with a foul.
How about the play by Sundiata Gaines over there? He knew he was going to get fouled. Jumped up in the air and drew the foul. He's hobbled a little bit. He had an ankle sprain earlier in the year that really caused him a lot of problems. Didn't play against Georgia Tech and then came back and got hurt in a game and then came back against Clemson and was not able to play.
Ramel Bradley getting his first foul as Gaines misses the free throw. Sundiata Gaines, the junior from Jamaica, New York, the Georgia MVP last year, led them in rebounds and assists. You don't see that too often. Second free throw, good, breaks the tie. Georgia by one.
He's back this year leading him in rebounds, assists, and steals.
Yep.
That's a pretty good job.
Ray Thomas driving off the high post. Blocked partially by Singleton, who rips it down for Georgia. Duke looking inside. Nothing there. Takes it baseline. Mercer. Off balance shot. Not a good shot. Rebounded by Crawford. Somehow able to get the pass away as he fell down Crawford. And then Orbshutis fouled as he takes it to the rim. Łukasz Orbshut, the senior from Poland.
Pretty good ball movement here by Meeks to get the ball to Crawford. And then he just dropped the ball down to Orbshut as he was trying to go in for the layup. What that is, that's just filling a gap. When you see an opening like that, make sure you fill that opening, get there, and if the guy's got the basketball, one of your teammates, in most cases, he'll find you.
Brown committing the Georgia foul. Kentucky with
number one, Michael Porter in for Kentucky.
Michael Porter coming in to replace Crawford. And Meeks already in there. Meeks, of course, is from this state, from Norcross, Georgia, as is Randolph Morris, who's on the bench currently for the Wildcats.
Kentucky already has played nine players. Georgia known for playing a lot of players. In fact, they've got 10 guys averaging 10 or more minutes.
And here's Billy Humphrey with the ball. He's in the lineup for the first time for Georgia. 6'2 sophomore. Woodbury, Terrence Woodbury, 6'7 sophomore, Virginia Beach. There he is.
Good defense by Kentucky to keep the ball out of the middle.
Gaines pops a three and came up short. Wanted a foul, couldn't get the call. And Kentucky will come up court in a 7-7 game.
Bradley in a hurry.
Thomas saves. Here's Meeks for three. Long rebound, taken on the fly by the Bulldogs. 3-pointer from the corner, good by Woodbury.
He's one of those five guys I was talking about who can shoot the three.
Kentucky tries to beat the defense back down court, and they get a foul as Meeks sprints to the rim.
Georgia foul, number
Foul on Singleton. Log on now to lfsports.com for a chance to join us at an upcoming game as part of the Bell South One of the Crew contest. You and a guest who in a VIP trip to a basketball telecast. Go behind the scenes with our broadcast crew. Check out lfsports.com for complete rules and details. Jody Meeks at the free throw line gets his first point. The freshman from Norcross, Georgia, Norcross High School. 5A state champions last season. In fact, he had 32 points in the title game and was 5A player of the year.
He had a terrific year, Tom. I mean, when I live in Atlanta and have a chance to read the papers, the high school papers, in the morning, of course, after they won it, they just raved about this young man. He had a terrific high school career.
He was also a state finalist in the long jump.
Mm-hmm.
And his dad was an All-American long jumper at Middle Tennessee. Jody born in Nashville, but high school in Norcross, Georgia. Bulldogs lead trimmed to one. Woodbury lost it, picked up by Porter. Numbers for the Cats. Crawford, three and one.
Pretty. You know, the ability to take a blow like that, after you have increased your muscle mass, and you can take that kind of punishment and still get that basket, that's how important off-season work is right here. I mean, he got bumped pretty good and was still able to get the shot up and off the glass.
Got bumped by a 260-pounder at that, as Singleton commits his second foul.
Well, that's where all that off-season work comes into play. You know, Crawford really did reduce his body fat. I mean, he really increased himself, at least his muscle mass, made him a much stronger player this year, and I think it's made him a better player.
Singleton to the Georgia bench with his second foul. Albert Jackson makes his first appearance. 6'10 freshman from Arlington, Kentucky. Kentucky leads by two. Woodbury missing a three. Crawford, dangerous pass. Porter able to get it. Stevenson, who's into the lineup for Kentucky, fumbling for a moment and handing to Porter, back to Stevenson, fumbled it again. Hit the underneath side of the rim. Freshman having a rough possession. Porter, three. Front rim not there. Crawford with a follow.
Well, what a night Crawford is having. Great start for Joe Crawford. Triple team
and a steal. Here's Meeks. Two on two. Meeks should have backed it out, but is lucky he was fouled by Gaines.
Gotta tell you, Kentucky's defense has been stellar the last three or four possessions that Georgia had the ball on offense. They've not allowed them to get any good clean shots, and they that time triple teamed on the inside, and there was no way that Albert Jackson could move with the basketball. Kentucky doing a good job of their defense tonight.
And Joe Crawford doing a good job scoring. He has 11 of Kentucky's 14 points. Kentucky on a 7-0 run since the 14 and a half minute mark. Crawford, crossover dribble, goes baseline and is fouled by Woodbury. Joe Crawford continues to steam for the Wildcats.
Tough matchup for Woodbury at 6'7". Crawford very quick with the basketball. On his way to the basket that time and stopped short by a foul.
Fifth against Georgia. Corey into the game for Kentucky. Little U sees some playing time early here. Crawford penetrates off the glass high and he got it. 13 points for Joe Crawford.
Well, he's getting them from everywhere, isn't he?
Beautiful drive that time. Answering three, no good by Humphrey. Georgia retains.
Good pass.
Newman underneath. Got it.
Good look that time by Sunday out of Gaines. Newman deserved that basket. He went in there and got the offensive rebound to keep it alive.
Skip pass to Porter. Wide open. Three-pointer on its way. Good.
Cats are shooting threes tonight. And they're making them.
Newman's going to shoot a three. Back rim, long rebound. Humphrey claims it. Jump stop, Humphrey up and under. Nice move.
Well, and Porter went right by him. Good fake sending by. There goes Crawford right back again.
Crawford perfect so far tonight. That's his first miss in six attempts.
Well, the pace has picked up, hasn't it?
Newman, low post, spinning. Dishing out, Woodbury's three. Good!
You got to guard those three-point shooters the Bulldogs have. Woodbury's one of them.
Kentucky's hit three of six from the arc. And Georgia, only one. Not couldn't be right. They have more than one, don't they? Stat monitors have one of five. Can't trust those computers.
Porter with a good move down inside, off of the glass.
Michael Porter's first basket.
You gotta stay with those computers. I told you that.
Humphrey, three-pointer. No good. And a held ball on the rebound. Alternate possession will give it to the Wildcats. Joe Crawford has been on fire early. Crawford with 13 of the Wildcats' points.
We're about to launch our freshest, tastiest chicken ever.
Good luck, Oscar!
Drop in to Ruby Tuesday.
Now when you bundle new services with Bell South, you get up to $300 cash back, which can have quite an effect on people.
There is nothing quite as wonderful as money.
There is nothing quite as beautiful as cash.
It doesn't take a scholar to know the value of a dollar. With money you can make a splash.
There is nothing quite as wonderful as money. Money.
Bundle services and get up to $300 cash back. Call today.
We're about to launch our freshest, tastiest chicken ever.
Fire!
Drop in to Ruby Tuesday.
Over 5 tons of towing capacity. 2,010 pounds of payload. It seems in thinking ahead, our engineers left nothing behind. Introducing the more comfortable, more powerful, more capable, all-new 2007 GMC Sierra. We examined everything and overlooked nothing, then backed it with the GM 100,000-mile warranty. That's professional grade.
Hope you're enjoying our Altel SEC Game of the Week. This week from Stegman Coliseum in Athens, Georgia Bulldogs and the Kentucky Wildcats.
Well, how about Joe Crawford tonight? You think he's off to a good start? I'd say so. He's got 13 points. Here's one of his three-point field goals. He's made three of those. Here's the second one right in front of the Georgia bench. There's a nice little maneuver inside as he drew the foul down in there from Rashad Singleton. Joe Crawford showing you a little bit of his resume tonight. It's going to take a little bit of a blow right now as Kentucky leads by four.
21-17 with 10 and a half minutes showing on the clock. 5 of 6 field goals. In fact, he's hit 5 of 6. The rest of the Kentucky team, just 2 of 7. Georgia shooting is 7 of 15.
Bulldogs have gone to his own defense. It's a 2-3 matchup. Good pass by Corey.
And Jasper laid it in.
Oh, what a good look by Corey. I mean, just a little flip pass to the backside.
Falling away three, Stooks no good. Jasper leads the Kentucky break. Lost the ball for a minute, went back to get it.
Georgia stays in that zone defense. You can see they're in a 2-3. They'll match up, pass players on. Once a guy leaves his zone, he goes to another one. Communication important in a zone.
Kentucky not getting into penetration, shot clock. Now down to 5. Stevenson from Jasper. They finally were patient and got the Stevenson layup.
Good pass by Jasper, too. Two good passes in a row and 2 possessions by Kentucky.
Here's Steele. Leads to an open three from the corner. No good by Mercer. Bradley, numbers for the Wildcats. Pull up, Perry, glass, no good. Rimmed out. Mercer the other way. That pass off Brown's back. He wasn't looking for the ball. Three on two, and Stevenson fumbles it. What's going on here? And a look at our Q Motor Oil Power 25. Florida, Alabama, LSU in the SEC. Kentucky was 25th in the AP poll last week, not ranked in the USA Today ESPN poll. Then they got beat by Vanderbilt, they breaking their 11-game losing streak, and they fell out of the AP poll and into the other one.
Go figure. It's like the RPI. I haven't figured that out yet, and they've had that out for about 5 or 6 years now. I'm trying to explain it to everybody. I'm getting better at it, though.
Mercer with his first foul puts Randolph Morris at the free throw line. Kentucky's been on a hot streak. They've hit six of their last eight shots from the floor. And Morris, the Atlanta native, rims it down. Got the second one as well.
Morris shooting his free throws much better this year.
Look at the Aaron scoreboard as Kentucky has claimed a 10-point lead. Stoops beat the defense back down court, laid it in.
Levi Stoops. He and Gaines are a great pair of guards out there for Georgia. Both of them experienced.
Jasper baseline, nice dish. Stevenson with a slam.
How about the passing by Kentucky tonight? The interior passing has been outstanding in this first half.
Bliss nearly traveled, did travel.
Nice pass again. Stevenson finishing it off on another good pass by Derek Jasper. I tell you, the Cats really looking for each other tonight on offense.
Georgia's just committed its fifth turnover. Kentucky's gotten 7 points off those five turnovers. The Wildcats have only turned it over twice. Bradley, Bliss picked him up, cut him off. Jasper threw a bad pass. Intercepted by Georgia. Stoops. I don't know how that one got through, but it did. And Mercer put it home.
That looked like a bowling ball. It's just rolling down through there until somebody picked it up.
One thing for sure in this game, you better hustle back on defense because they're coming at you. Here's Morris underneath, over Bliss, no good. Put in by Stevenson.
Well, good first half off of the bench tonight by Perry Stevenson.
Pull up shot, no good by Brown.
Kentucky really breaking now, Tom. A lot of fast breaks in this first half for the Wildcats.
Bradley missing an open three. Kept alive, though, by Crawford. Kentucky sets up again on the half court. Jasper penetrates, dishes to Morris. Took the blow and laid it in.
Surprised that wasn't a foul. He got banged pretty good going up there. And Kentucky's gone to his own. 2-3. Sometimes teams will use this as a breather.
Shooting over it. Stoops can't hit. Morris had it for a moment, then Brown blocked from behind by Stevenson. And out of bounds to Kentucky. Boy, Stevenson doing a great job, the freshman off the Kentucky bench, and the Wildcats looking good. They have their biggest lead. They're up 33-21 in Athens.
If you're looking to ramp up your ride, get ready. Advance Auto Parts has a special order center just for you. Your one-of-a-kind, one-stop shop for everything you could ever want in parts and performance accessories. Everything from lift kits to cool custom accessories is ready for direct-to-your-door delivery or convenient in-store pickup. When you want the most complete selection of parts and accessories, the only place to go is the special order center in Advance Auto Parts. We're ready in advance.
Whether it's fire danger, a serious fall, or other type of emergency, Life Alert is there for you.
The first time I fell in that bedroom, and I couldn't reach the phone.
When you have a heart attack like I did, and there's no one there, Life Alert was there for me.
Having a secure feeling through Life Alert is ideal.
My independence is possible because of it.
Now, Life Alert can also protect you in a fire emergency with a system that automatically notifies our monitoring center.
Thanks to Life Alert, you can live alone without ever being alone. And that's why I wear one.
all senior citizens should have Life Alert.
Please call 1-800-693-5620 for free information about Life Alert. That's 1-800-693-5620, or visit us on the web at the address on your screen. Don't delay. Call us now at 1-800-693-5620.
Soft Thursday on MSN.
Southeastern Conference basketball on the Lincoln Financial Sports Network, coming your way from Stegman Coliseum in Georgia. The Wildcats and the Bulldogs, Tom Hammond, Larry Conley. And to remind you, the announcers for this game selected and compensated by Jet Lincoln Financial Sports. The use of the broadcast without the express permission of the Southeastern Conference and Lincoln Financial Sports is prohibited. Some important things helping Kentucky to that 33-21 lead, Larry. First of all, they've gotten 14 points off their bench. They're hitting their threes, and perhaps most importantly, with those 12 of 21 field goals, they have 9 assists for the dozen field goals.
When you're getting 75% of your baskets and they have an assist attached to them, you're doing really well.
Morris spinning fallaway shot and a beauty. Randolph Morris, he's getting on track. He has a half dozen points.
Tom, I really think he's improved his position. I mean, his offensive game has really gotten much, much better down low.
Mercer tried to get it to Jackson, but a foul. It's on Randolph Morris. That'll be his second. It'll send him to the bench.
If there's one thing he hasn't improved on, though, is his fouling.
Well, he actually has improved it, but he still sometimes commits some unnecessary ones like that one.
Exactly.
Your point's well taken. But he has actually gotten better. Tuffy Smith's leaving him out there with two. Normally, exiles you to the bench for the rest of the half. Brown to Jackson, nowhere to go. Morris didn't want to foul him, but Thomas did.
Actually, I thought Brown had a better opportunity at the basket than did Jackson. He could have gone in there and maybe floated to the right a little bit to get away from Morris, but made the pass, and Jackson was able to make the basket and maybe pick up an extra point out of this.
Sheree Thomas with the foul. Jackson bricks the free throw, but Mercer takes the odd rebound. And now Stoops with penetration. And a dish outside, three-pointer, no good. Gaines couldn't hit it. Here's Crawford. Porter spotted three, no good. Front rim, Gaines running out against Crawford. Wow, what a shot, Sunday out of Gaines.
How about that move? I mean, he was being wedged to the right side, forced away from the basket, and was still able to get that runner off the glass. That was a terrific move.
His third point pulls Georgia back within 10. Coming to the 5-minute mark in this first half. Crawford's fall away. He's still hot. 15 first half points for Crawford, who averages 14 a game. In the double figures, 8 straight games. He's been really hot during conference play and has taken it up a notch here at Athens tonight. Gaines with the feet inside. Jackson. Here's Mercer. Mercer draws the foul. Watch for the Geico College Basketball Campus Tour, season-long traveling exhibit celebrating the greatest shooters of all time. Go to lfsports.com for more information. Find out when Geico will be visiting a college campus near you.
How about the Bulldogs? Offensively on the break, watch this terrific play by Sunday out of Gaines. I mean, he's floating away from the basket there, forced out by Crawford, and he was still able to get that runner high off the window.
Meanwhile, Larry, Randolph Morris has picked up his third foul. Tubby Smith over there questioning, but he has been charged, Randolph Morris, with his third foul with under 5 minutes to go in this first half. Meeks with a nice backdoor cut.
How about the delivery by Stevenson? The recognition, the two freshmen working together in tandem. Good cut by Meeks, good pass by Stevenson.
Kentucky passing has been a thing of beauty so far tonight. But Randolph Morris to the bench with his third foul. He was just getting on track too. He scored 6 points. He leaves the game at the 4:28 mark, first half. Gaines. standing like a statue was Sherrod Thomas. He didn't move a whisker. He was rigid, just standing there like he had rigor mortis and just fell down crack against the floor.
Reminds me of those loggers that used to cut those trees down. You just hit one and it just kind of fell slowly.
Timber. Joe Crawford, he's hit 6 of 7 shots tonight.
Oh, he's doing a nice job of handling the ball right now, too. Bad shot there. Forced it.
Numbers for the Bulldogs. Stoops spotted for the three. Rimmed out. And here's Meeks. 3-on-2.
Nice.
Stevenson fumbled the pass, or he had a layup, and then missed underneath. Just can't make the catch, the freshman.
Got to get your hands on the ball. That's the first thing you've got to do. Well, that was a good pass by Meeks, too.
Done everything else well, but he's fumbled that ball on numerous occasions. Porter with a block of the Stoop shot, then he takes it down. Pass to Crawford. Crawford pulls up, the shot good. Joe Crawford with 17, count them, 17 first half points.
Oh, what a start. He got off to a great start, and he has not let up.
Only missed two shots.
Kentucky doing a nice job on Georgia defensively.
Pull up shot, Gaines. Stevenson at position for the rebound. Kentucky's done a good job taking care of the ball. They committed 18 turnovers here last year, only 3 so far tonight. Thomas underneath gets wide open for the shot. Kentucky making those good passes are really getting the high percentage shots.
Well, and what's making it work is the fact that they're getting in the right position at the right time.
And we'll be back to the Stegman Coliseum with the Wildcats lead right after this message from the University of Kentucky.
Check.
With a $22 million grant, University of Kentucky is reforming math and science in grades K through 12. And it shows in better test scores and more interest in both subjects. To learn more about how UK is changing the state, visit uky.edu.
Smart girls can rule the
calculator right here.
43-26. Kentucky with a big lead with 2.5 minutes to go in this first half against the Georgia Bulldogs, who were favored at home tonight. Aaron's scoreboard. North Carolina leading Wake. Some SEC action here. South Carolina and Arkansas. Tennessee and Ole Miss. Vandy and LSU coming up later. And Florida and Mississippi State.
How about those Auburn Tigers last night jumping on the Crimson Tide, huh?
And good.
Yeah, did they ever. Hey, Jeff Lebo's team has gotten better, it seems like, progressively almost every week.
Well, they beat Tennessee when we were there a week ago.
Mm-hmm.
Followed that up with the thrashing of Alabama, their arch rival last night. Woodbury, three-pointer, air ball, just maybe grazed the front of the rim, and everything falling apart for the Bulldogs. Over the last 2 minutes, Kentucky has gone on an 8-1 run. And the Wildcats in control in Athens.
Did I tell you I switched to the new Fast Access DSL Extreme 6.0?
Cable downloads are like lightning.
I can download like lightning.
Yeah, 10 meg file download.
Yeah.
Uncompressed photo files.
You bet.
Danny, online video gaming.
Sure.
Movie downloads.
Oh, yeah.
The new Fast Access DSL Extreme 6.0. It's all the speed you'll ever need and more. Plus, call now and get $225 cash back when you switch from cable internet to Bell South.
Got it. Big honking email it.
It's the SEC Men's Basketball Tournament Championship, and you've got the chance to win the best seat in the house. Log on to secsports.com and then enter yourself to win the grand prize. An SEC Ultimate Basketball Weekend in Atlanta. VIP treatment across the board, and best of all, you get a courtside seat with the SEC Radio Network. To get any closer, you'd have to suit up. Brought to you by all the proud corporate sponsors of the SEC. It's the SEC Ultimate Basketball Weekend.
How can it be offensive if it's true?
Okay, first of all,
Not 100% in love with your tone right now.
Tone aside, historically, you guys have struggled to adapt.
Yeah, right. Walking upright, discovering fire, inventing the wheel, laying the foundation for all mankind. You're right. Good point. Sorry we couldn't get that to you sooner.
Connie, your reaction?
Sounds like someone woke up on the wrong side of the rock.
GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Well, a lot of glum faces in the Stegman Coliseum tonight, even the little ones, as the homestanding Bulldogs have fallen down 17 to the Wildcats here in the first half. I don't think anybody expected that, even the Kentucky fans.
So they jumped out quickly and really on the shoulders of Joe Crawford. I mean, once he got the offense rolling and everybody else has kind of joined in now. In fact, Kentucky's really played a little bit better since Morris went out of the lineup.
Look at this lineup now. It's Bobby Perry, Porter, Corey, Meeks, and Jasper. Mark Corey, the freshman forward from Detroit, seeing some playing time in the first half. Had it for a moment, then lost it to Corey. Humphrey turned away by Meeks.
Kentucky's gone back to that man-to-man. They've gone away from that zone. Set in a couple of minutes. Good pass inside by Brown.
And the finish by Humphrey. Meeks. Pass deflected by Bliss and stolen. He knocks Corey down just to prove his point. And Bliss goes up strong and draws the foul.
I almost thought Bliss was going to get that basket by default because he started at the other end. Once he got it, he pushed his way down inside, got there, got in position. He was going to get this ball up no matter what. He got hammered as he went up.
Corey fouled him, so Bliss will go to the line. He has not scored tonight.
He's a young man who has played in small amounts, if you will. He's had a herniated disc problem, and it has bothered him for some time now. And Dennis Felton just gives him, 4 to 5 minutes, and then gets him out of there. But he does give him good minutes when he's out there. Big, big, wide body.
And a perennial member of the SEC Academic Honor Roll, he is an honors student in honors political science, a Dean's List student. His high school valedictorian in Wausau West High School in Wisconsin.
Every time I think of Wausau, I think of that train station.
In the commercial?
In the commercial.
One minute to go in the half.
1-4 set by Kentucky. Cats moving the ball pretty well tonight.
Bliss has to pick up Crawford. And that'll be an offensive foul on Joe Crawford. Lower his shoulder and is called for the offensive foul, his first foul.
Take another look at it. You'll see Joe Crawford right here in the middle. Step right to the elbow and pretty good position and probably the proper call right there.
Fifth turnover by Kentucky. George has turned it over 7 times. So Humphrey brings it up court for the Bulldogs. 40 seconds left in the half.
Good pressure defense by Kentucky.
Bradley all over Humphrey. Now Brown. Thomas has him. Spins baseline, draws a double team and a triple team. Out of bounds.
Brown's a little slow to react down there. I mean, if you don't get that ball out of there, if you're going to make a move, you better get it up on the rim quickly. If you catch, you're going to expect a double or triple team from Kentucky, and that's what the Cats did that time.
22 seconds in the half, 12 to shoot, and counting. Shot clock at 8. 5 to shoot. Humphrey with 3 on the shot clock. Rimmed out, and Kentucky has it. Meeks dribbled it off Bradley's heel. But Perry able to save it. Tubby Smith frantically calling for a timeout. Gets it with 4 seconds left.
I thought he was going to go out and play. He was about 8 or 10 feet out on the floor trying to yell to the official.
So 4 seconds left, timeout on the floor, and as the teams discuss strategy, you should too. Get someone to talk with you, not at you. Talk to Chuck, Charles Schwab.
Tough break for Kentucky. They had a break going that way as Tubby Smith continues his conversation with his team. He's got a 4 second play over there. He's drawing up. And they're going to have the ball in the backcourt, so they've got to make at least one long pass before they get in position to get their offense going.
So 4 seconds on the clock in this first half of play, a half that has seen Kentucky run away from the Georgia Bulldogs with some excellent passing and the offensive fireworks from Joe Crawford.
See how Kentucky handles this into the half here. Bradley's going to bring it up quickly.
1 second, three by Bradley, no good at the buzzer. But the Kentucky Wildcats will go to the locker room with a surprisingly big lead.
Probably the only thing they could do is let Ramel Bradley bring it up. He got the one pass at Georgia's free throw line and just maybe another 2 or 3 inches over that rim. He had another basket.
60% shooting for the Wildcats. Joe Crawford with 15 points in the first half on 6 of 7 shooting.
SEC basketball is brought to you by Bell South. By Aaron Sales and Lease Ownership. By GMC. By Q Motor Oil. And by Ruby Tuesday.
I'm from Chattanooga, Tennessee. And my buddy here, Luke, he's from Macedonia. I grew up off of crystals. Luke here, he's had crystals for a year. He thinks he's the crystal expert.
Every time I get like a big sack, I always finish everything and he never does.
That's a crystal.
That's a crystal.
With cheese on it, it's called a cheese crystal. This is the incredible crystal chick right here. I can't finish a whole sack, I admit it.
See, look at this, it takes half an hour, now I have to talk. Oh, what, are you gonna say something to me?
Try new saucy chicks. They're chicks that are dipped in sauce.
You should be ashamed of yourself, really.
I was proud of what our league had been able to do. You could have a SEC team win a national championship and the NIT in the same year.
You got to live in the moment and go out there and play as a team. There's going to be adversity and there's going to be challenges. It's not about the past and it's not about the future. It's about right now.
You want the candy? You can't have the candy. They call me the bus driver kid because I'm about to take you to school. Vader! Oh! Oh! Oh!
Man, I send this to everybody.
Hey.
What are you guys looking at?
Nothing.
Catch My Circle Mania. Text HOOPS to 84353 for a chance to win $100,000.
For 30 straight years, we've been America's best-selling truck. But we won't celebrate with fireworks or party hats, because this is about you, not us. It's about giving you the truck you need, the truck that gets the job done. It's how we build them. Yesterday, today, and tomorrow, Ford trucks, built Ford tough. Now get an F-150 Supercab XLT 4x2 for just $309 a month with zero down, zero due at signing, and zero first month's payment. See your local Ford dealer.
Chevrolet presents the SEC Community Service Team, recognizing the superior community service efforts of league basketball players. Today's honoree is junior center Dave Bliss from the University of Georgia. Dave's a participant in reading and mentoring programs through the Athens-Clarke County school system. He's also a volunteer with the Northeast Georgia Food Bank and Habitat for Humanity, and he assisted with Hurricane Katrina relief efforts last fall. Chevrolet is proud to salute Dave Bliss for being named a member of the SEC Community Service Team. To learn more about the team, visit lfsports.com.
Follow our coverage of SEC basketball all season long by logging on to lfsports.com and check out the Toyota Info Center. That's the Toyota Info Center on lfsports.com, your online destination for our coverage of SEC basketball. Surprising score at halftime. The Kentucky Wildcats with a superb first half of play, leading by 13 over Georgia, thanks to the play of Joe Crawford. Crawford hitting 7 of 9 shots in that first half. The computer was down, so we haven't had an updated. He did miss 2 shots. He has 17 points at halftime. You said 15 a moment ago, but the computer is down, so we have verified that Joe Crawford was 17 first half points. He was really in a rhythm. When a shooter gets in that rhythm, he was putting it on the floor. He was hitting from outside. He was doing it all.
And
what a half by Kentucky.
You're right, Tom. And the thing about it is, when you get one player like that, everybody else, it's like a wave. Everybody just kind of jumps on the wave and just kind of rides it. And I thought the play of Kentucky in the first half was outstanding, particularly their interior passing. It was outstanding.
And off the bench, they got some terrific play.
They did. And the thing about it is that Tubby Smith played a lot of players tonight, more than I've ever seen him play in the first half. He cleared that entire bench. Everybody got a few minutes.
The only sad spot for the Wildcats is Randolph Morris in foul trouble with 3. It hadn't seemed to matter so far. Let's look at our Advanced Auto Parts now drive to the SEC Championship standings. And in the East, Florida, the lone remaining unbeaten in league play at 4-0. Top-ranked Gators, with Kentucky now having lost at home at 4-1. Georgia comes in at 3-2.
And as I said, in the Western Division, it is a just toss it up, and let's see who's going to win it. Right now, we don't have a team with a winning record over there, but Alabama, LSU, Mississippi State, Arkansas, Auburn, right there contending. I think Ole Miss is still a tough place to go play. I think they're going to be hard to beat at home.
Well, road wins have been hard to come by in the SEC this season, but Kentucky looking good at halftime of this one.
About to launch our freshest, tastiest chicken ever. Drop in to Ruby Tuesday.
Why does that bother you?
Why does it bother me? So easy a caveman can do it?
Well, it's just a commercial.
Okay. Well, what if it said Geico.com, so easy a therapist can do it?
Well, that commercial wouldn't make sense to me.
Why not?
Well, therapists are...
Are what? Smart? My mother's calling. I'll put it on speaker.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Who's going to beat Aaron's when it comes to great service and brand new, brand name furniture, electronics, appliances, and computers? Who's going to beat Aaron's guaranteed lowest prices whether you buy outright or lease to own? Who's going to beat Aaron's when it comes to treating customers right, like our flexible payment plans and no credit checks? Well, I'll tell you who. Nobody beats Aaron's. Call us right now and let us prove it.
Do the math.
Nobody beats Aaron's.
We're about to launch our freshest, tastiest chicken ever.
Good luck, Oscar!
Drop in to Ruby Tuesday.
Everything's getting faster, sexier, and yet less expensive. So, why not cars? Say hello to the G6 sedan, G6 coupe, and G6 hardtop convertible. G6, one of the fastest growing brands in America. Pontiac, designed for action.
Working to protect people from bird flu and other emerging global diseases.
Exploring new ways to combat diabetes and obesity.
Developing new treatments for AIDS and drug-resistant cancers.
Innovative techniques to combat Alzheimer's, Huntington's, and Parkinson's diseases.
The University of Georgia.
The University of Georgia.
The University of Georgia.
America's emerging public health leader.
Today's Rejection of the Week is brought to you by Sonic.
Rejected!
This week's rejection comes from Auburn, Alabama, where Auburn's Rasheen Barrett rejects Tennessee guard Chris Lofton. And that's our Sonic Rejection of the Week.
Rejected!
Don't forget a doubleheader and an Alltel SEC doubleheader this Saturday on most of these stations at 1 Eastern, noon Central. The Vanderbilt Commodores will host the Ole Miss Rebels. And then at 3 Eastern, 2 Central, Arkansas travels to Tuscaloosa to meet 12th-ranked Alabama. Tim Brando and Larry Conley in the Ole Miss Vanderbilt game. Dave Baker, Joe Dean, Arkansas and Alabama. Check your local listings for the doubleheader, the Alltel doubleheader, on most of these Lincoln Financial Sports stations. And for those of you viewers watching tonight's game on FSN South and Sun Sports, stay tuned immediately following this game. We'll join Dave Neal and Barry Booker in Starkville for Mississippi State and Florida. Take a look, Larry, at our crystal scoreboard now.
Arkansas and South Carolina in the first half at Columbia, tied 12-12. Tar Heels pushed out to a little bit of a lead over Wake Forest. North Carolina playing very well. Later on tonight, you can see Tennessee and Ole Miss and Vandy and LSU squaring off in just a few more minutes.
And here in Athens, Kentucky led by as many as 17 in that first half. They're up 13 now at the break.
I really like this breakfast bistro sandwich. This bacon is great.
Well, you know, in Italy, bacon is called pancetta.
How do you know that?
As a guy, I pretty much know everything there is to know about bacon. It's encoded into our DNA at birth.
I have some things encoded on my DNA.
Oh, yeah?
Like I'm able to sense when you're just full of it.
Bacon breakfast bistro sandwich, only at Sonic. Bacon, eggs, and cheese on toasted ciabatta bread. Try one with the cranberry juice or any other juice, because Sonic is your ultimate drink stop.
It's the SEC Men's Basketball Tournament Championship, and you've got the chance to win the best seat in the house. Log on to secsports.com and then enter yourself to win the grand prize. An SEC Ultimate Basketball Weekend in Atlanta. VIP treatment across the board, and best of all, you get a courtside seat with the SEC Radio Network. To get any closer, you'd have to suit up. Brought to you by all the proud corporate sponsors of the SEC. It's the SEC Ultimate Basketball Weekend.
Daddy, what happens if our house burns up in a fire?
We'll build a new one.
What happens if our house gets blown away in a tornado?
We'll build a new one.
What happens if our house gets smashed by an asteroid?
We'll build a new one then, too.
Daddy, what happens if the asteroid hits you?
Recently, Car and Driver held a head-to-head comparison. 600 car enthusiasts were asked to compare three cars in performance, handling, and styling. So who won? Camry? Accord? Actually, the all-wheel drive Ford Fusion came in first. Check it out yourself. Visit a Ford dealer or go to FusionChallenge.com. Now just sign and drive off with zero down, zero first month's payment, and zero due at signing. Lease a Ford Fusion for only $249 a month. Take the Fusion Challenge today.
Ruby Tuesday presents the Play of the Week. This week's play comes from Florida forward Joakim Noah, who follows a missed jumper with a thunderous two-handed jam. The Gators' victory over Ole Miss kept them unbeaten in SEC play and atop the national poll. And that's our Ruby Tuesday Play of the Week.
Halftime in Athens, Kentucky leading Georgia 43-30. Larry, it's hard to imagine a better half of basketball than what we saw Kentucky put up.
Yeah, they had a terrific first half, and of course it was Joe Crawford that led the way, and because we showed him so much in the first half, we're not going to show him here in the highlights at halftime. We'll give you some other guys that really played very well for Kentucky and for Georgia, too. Here are our highlights. Here's Michael Porter draining a three for Kentucky. He had a good first half, too. Nice pass inside to Perry Stevenson, who finishes it off, and off the bench, he played very well. Corey with a terrific pass down inside to the waiting Derek Jasper. For the Georgia Bulldogs, this is their first basket right here. A nice pass inside to Takeyus Brown, who finished it off. Sunday out of Gaines with that nice maneuver, that running shot. And again, Brown delivering a nice pass to Albert Jackson inside, and he gets fouled and goes to the line. Pretty good movement of the ball by the Bulldogs on that play.
Here are the halftime stats. Kentucky shooting nearly 57%, only 37 for Georgia. Kentucky hitting the free throws, three-point shooting, two baskets and 15 attempts for Georgia, well below what they normally do. Points in the paint in favor of the Wildcats, and they force seven Georgia turnovers. Wildcats led by as many as 17. Eight different Kentucky players have scored. Nine players have scored for Georgia.
If you're looking to ramp up your ride, get ready. Advance Auto Parts has a special order center just for you. your one-of-a-kind, one-stop shop for everything you could ever want in parts and performance accessories. Everything from lift kits to cool custom accessories is ready for direct-to-your-door delivery or convenient in-store pickup. When you want the most complete selection of parts and accessories, the only place to go is the Special Order Center in Advance Auto Parts.
We're ready in advance.
The ring gear on many half-tons out there is this big. The one you want is this big. How you like them apples? Available on the all-new full-size Tundra. Learn more at Toyota.com.
For years, the front brakes on many half-tons were this big. You wanted brakes this big. Bingo. Standard on the all-new full-size Tundra. Learn more at Toyota.com.
Our hometown. Where we live, where we love, where the simple life is good enough. Where we dream, where we hope, where we stand together and share the load. Oh, our hometown is blessed. Farm Bureau Insurance, helping you is what we do best.
V-Dub here in full effect with Trey and his ride. What time is it?
I don't know.
Time to unpimp the auto. Oh, snap! German engineering in the house.
The Volkswagen GTI. 2007 Automobile of the Year.
SEC basketball is being brought to you by Red Lobster, by Pontiac, by Charles Schwab, by Advance Auto Parts, by Sonic Drive-In, and by Toyota.
Tom Hammond, Larry Connolly, Stegman Coliseum in Athens, ready to start the second half. On Saturday, Georgia had the big lead in Tuscaloosa, saw Alabama come back. They're hoping to do the same here at home tonight against Kentucky. The Wildcats up 13 at halftime. And Lukasz Orbszuk will start the second half for Kentucky in place of Randolph Morris, who picked up three first half fouls. Bliss backing him down, made a ball fake. And Perry fouled him on the arm as he took it up. Kentucky led by Joe Crawford at halftime with 17 first half points. Morris had six before he picked up that third foul. Stevenson off the bench for a half dozen. Porter and Meeks also reserves for the Wildcats.
Four of the top five scores for Kentucky were off the bench.
Nobody in double figures for Georgia. Bliss rolls in the free throw.
Georgia needs to establish themselves quickly here in this second half, at least in the beginning. The first 5 minutes, very important for them to get off and get off well.
They have their original starting five, Brown, Mercer, Bliss, Stoops, and Gaines. Kentucky with Orbszuk, along with the other starters, Bradley, Perry, Jasper. Jasper, who cuts baseline, missed the reverse. And Crawford, the fifth Kentucky player.
Gaines. Nice pass.
And down with a throwdown. And the Bulldogs off to the good start to open the second half. 4 point for Brown.
Nice move by Gaines that time.
Jasper way out of the floor. Perry given room, but passes up the shot. And runs the offense instead.
Well, Georgia with much tougher pressure defense this half.
Here's the man who carried the Wildcats in the first half, Crawford, three-pointer, air ball. Gaines takes it in a hurry. Mercer, Bliss called him for it wide open, they missed him. Stoops, penetration, defense collapses on him. Ball loose on the court, hell ball. Possession arrow to the Wildcats.
Georgia with the basketball, good push here by Sundiata Gaines, dropping it off. Down the inside to a wide open teammate, Takeus Brown, and here's the follow by Brown again.
But after Georgia got it back, they turned it over for the eighth time and actually had Bliss breaking down the court with no one within 10 feet of him and missed him right under the basket. Instead, Kentucky will take over looking for their first points. A lot of dribbling by Bradley. Again, this is what Tubby Smith does not want.
But somebody's got to get open. Kentucky having difficulty shaking anybody up front.
Bradley fumbled the pass, and there's five to shoot. Three to shoot. Turned it over. Levi Stoops comes the other way for the Dogs. Georgia's defense much more active here in the second half. Jump hook by Brown. Got the roll to Kaius Brown.
Georgia making a good run here.
They're within seven with that 10-0 run. Bradley for three, air ball. And a foul. It'll be on Jody Meeks. W. Smith quickly going to his bench here in the second half, getting Meeks and Thomas into the game. And Meeks commits his first foul.
Well, all of a sudden, this game just turned completely around. It did a 180. And as good as Kentucky was playing in the first half, Georgia's playing equally as well to start the second half.
A 10-0 run for the Bulldogs dating back to the end of the first half. And Perry to the bench, replaced by Stevenson. So only Joe Crawford and Ramel Bradley among the five starters for Kentucky on the court at the moment.
Just wondering how much longer Tubby Smith's going to leave Morris on that bench over there.
Kentucky's last field goal was with 2.5 minutes to play in the first half. Bliss fed it inside. Brown spinning, double teamed. Somebody got a piece of it, maybe Stevenson. And then Stevenson does reject the shot by Gaines. Here's Crawford, Georgia back on defense.
Well, Stevenson has a great ability to block shots.
Everybody took notice when he had seven in his first college game against Miami.
That would make you sit up and take notice.
Bradley with a back cut, open for a moment. Instead, Thomas bricks the fall away.
Georgia playing with much more determination to start this second half.
And feeding the ball inside. Brown got another one.
Tom, they don't have anybody that can match up with Takeus Brown right now. This may just require the move to get Morris back in there to guard him. And all of a sudden, Georgia's back.
The 13-point halftime lead has been trimmed to only five. Timeout Kentucky. The Bulldogs on a roll.
The dream is still alive, someday it will come true. And this country, it belongs to folks like me and you. So let the voice of freedom sing out through this land. This is our country.
This is our truck. The 2007 Motor Trend Truck of the Year. The all-new Chevy Silverado.
There are five ways to satisfy a jumbo shrimp craving, and only one place to do it. It's Jumbo Shrimp at Red Lobster, starting at $11.99. Choose your irresistible favorite, like hand-breaded jumbo crunch fried or mouth-watering jumbo scampi. Or try new Mediterranean jumbo shrimp pasta. Tender shrimp tossed in Italian herb butter with artichokes, fresh tomatoes, and sautéed onions. It's Jumbo Shrimp for a limited time, only at Red Lobster.
'Bout. You want the candy?
You can't have the candy. They call me the bus driver kid because I'm about to take you to school.
Vader!
Oh! Oh! Oh!
Man, I sent it to everybody.
Hey.
What are you guys looking at?
Nothing.
Catch My Circle Mania. Text HOOPS to 84353 for a chance to win $100,000.
Hope you're enjoying our Altel SEC Game of the Week, Stegman Coliseum in Athens. Kentucky had a 17-point lead at one point in the first half, but they haven't scored a field goal since 2.5 minutes to go in that half, and Georgia's been on the comeback, led by Takaeus Brown, who has 6 points already in this second half.
A little bit of help from his friends right there. Sunday out of games with a nice maneuver, and again, they feed the ball to him in the right position. Nice little bounce, the roll, and again, a good pass in there by Bliss to get Brown in the right position.
Georgia's hit 3 of 5 shots to open the second half, while Kentucky is 0 for 4, and Randolph Morris re-enters the Kentucky lineup. Morris with 6 points, left the game with 4.5 to go in the first half, and there is a 3-point shot by Jody Meeks.
The Georgian comes back to haunt Georgia.
Kentucky needed that one in the worst way. They go back up 46-38.
Bad maneuver by Mercer. He had nowhere to go.
And the ball winds up popping into the air, and then last touched by Singleton of Georgia, and the Bulldogs will turn it over. 15:58 left. Georgia's made a heroic comeback here to open the second half, but the three by Meeks helped the Wildcats.
Plus, their guard play is so much stronger. They can basically go 9 people deep and not lose anything.
You know? No, and the other guys are like starting maybe 6-man.
Right,
maybe if 6-man.
That, right, rejected. Don't you bring that weak tot action? You go strong in your mouth, or you don't go at all.
Coney and Tots. Satisfy your game day craving with an extra long chili cheese Coney and Tots. It's not just good, it's Sonic good.
If you have diabetes, then you know what this is. It's your lifeline. Luckily for us, these new meters are more accurate, they're easier to use, and the best news is you don't have to prick your fingers anymore. Access Diabetic Supply will send you one of these new meters, no charge. And if you have Medicare or private insurance, your testing supplies may also be covered. Call Access now to see if you qualify. They bill Medicare or your insurance company directly. There are no upfront costs, and they deliver your supplies right to your door for free. Call now and find out why thousands of people choose Access.
For more information, call 1-800-519-5990. Operators are standing by.
Access is America's choice for diabetic supplies. Call Access today. You'll be glad you did.
Go to Yahoo Sports to see over 45 Lincoln Financial Sports SEC basketball games. And for only $4.95 a month, you can hear thousands of audio broadcasts. Be sure and follow your favorite team all season long at Yahoo Sports. Just a couple of ticks. Under 16 minutes to go in the game. Randolph Morris returns to the lineup. He has 6 points in the first half before leaving with his third personal foul.
Tom, you know, this may be as much for defensive purposes as it is for offensive purposes, the way Takaeus Brown has started the second half. Bradley's back assuming the point guard position.
Playing the point. Putting out great minds. Bradley takes it back from Thomas, gets a screen. Launches a three. I don't know about that decision. That may put him somewhere else other than the point. Sherry Thomas able to save it on the long rebound. Lob it to Morris. Triple team and foul.
And why not? This big guy has been shouldering the load for most of this season so far inside. Kentucky needs to go to him offensively. Bulldogs really don't have much of an answer when Singleton is out fronting him like that. They've got to get some help from the backside. And it arrived a little bit late. Morris very quick to the basket with that move.
Stoops with the backside help instead gets his second foul. And puts Randolph Morris at the stripe. The Georgian from Landmark Christian. Prep All-American, 3 times All-State, returning to his home state here. Missed the second free throw and rebounded by Humphrey. Kentucky's in a man-to-man defense. Humphrey very quick with the ball. Couldn't get away from Meeks. Meeks doing a good job on Humphrey, isn't he? Singleton drew a crowd, got rid of it. Lob it for Singleton. No backside help till Crawford comes and then forces a travel. Again, Kentucky, it looked like Singleton would have an easy basket until Crawford came to help and a traveling call.
Yeah, one of the things in talking to Dennis Felton earlier in the year, he told me that Singleton was going to be a work in progress all year. He still hasn't been able to get that strength and use it the way he should. You catch a ball like that, you're 7 feet, you go up to the rims with strength, with power. He didn't do that.
Thomas faked the three. Crawford into Morris. Tapped by Thomas, but he was over the back of Gaines to do it. Sheree Thomas, second foul.
You got to battle Sunday out for Gaines for rebounds. I mean, this is a guy that's leading this club in rebounding from the guard position.
Third foul against Kentucky in the second half. Georgia's committed only one. Jackson sets a screen for Humphrey. Try to get it back to him, and Jackson a little slow getting to the rim. That's the 10th Georgia turnover.
And a nice move by Billy Humphrey. He had the right idea. The execution wasn't there because he didn't get the cooperation from his teammate. You know, that situation, Jackson's got to break to the basket. He would have been wide open.
14 minutes to play. Tonight's telecast featuring the University of Kentucky, brought to you in part by the Kentucky Farm Bureau. Jasper. Meeks for three.
Meeks has played well off the bench tonight. Had a good first half, very stable. Started out very strong here in the second half.
Kentucky's reclaimed a 12-point lead when Georgia was within five. A collision, which way does it go? Offensive foul, Stoops of Georgia.
Georgia foul.
Well, that's a good move and a good pass inside, outside by Derek Jasper. He gets it to Meeks right in the corner, who nails the three. I'll tell you one thing about Derek Jasper. He doesn't take a lot of shots. In fact, very few of them, but he makes a lot of them. He's a terrific passer. Sometimes I think he overpasses. Got to find that opening. Just think what the defense gives you.
Stoops just committed his third foul, goes to the Georgia bench. Georgia has not scored since Randolph Morris re-entered the game. Coincidentally or not. Remember, they were getting the ball to Takeus Brown right under the rim. And if nothing else, the size and bulk of Morris has prevented that. Crawford comes to claim the ball. Kentucky with seven to shoot. Five to shoot. Crawford, reach-in foul by Mercer. They were up against the shot clock. They were not going to get a good shot, and Mercer with a reach in commits the personal foul. Follow our coverage of SEC basketball all season long by logging on to lfsports.com. Check out the Toyota Info Center. Toyota Info Center, lfsports.com, your online destination for our coverage of SEC basketball.
Well, Mercer really bailed him out on that one. Kentucky really had no chance to get anything up on that rim.
Mercer's second. Morris. Fouled by Gaines, who reaches in on the big man.
How about the terrific pass by Jody Meeks? The screen set by Morris. He slipped the screens, rolled to the inside, and Meeks found him open in there. Kentucky again doing a nice job of passing the basketball. Watch this again. See, he just slipped the screen. Maybe a little push off, too, as he was heading in there.
Kentucky 7 of 9 now. 8 of 10 at the free throw line today. Good free throw shooting by the Wildcats as Humphrey is replaced by Woodbury. And Bradley for Crawford in the Kentucky lineup. Well, Kentucky appears to have weathered the storm that was the Georgia onslaught at the start of the half. as the Morris free throws put them up 52-38. Georgia has turned it over their last three possessions. Bliss with a solid screen. Calling for it down low, attacking Morris. Nowhere to go as Perry comes to help. Now Bliss still can't get set and get away from Morris. Comes out to get it. Thought about the three. Five to shoot. And Woodbury misses it. Kicks high over the backboard and out of bounds.
Good move, but just couldn't finish the product.
And the Georgia drought continues. Away from the ball, whistle and a foul. It's called on Perry of Kentucky for an illegal screen. His second. Well, the Georgia comeback to start the second half got the crowd into it. Things were rocking and rolling for the Dogs, and as quickly as that, Kentucky able to snuff it out.
Fizzle went out of it completely.
Bliss, outside shot, won't go. Kept alive and put in by Woodbury on the follow after Brown kept it alive. Fans wanted a push off on Meeks as he made the catch. No whistle.
Surprised that Meeks doesn't look for his shot a little bit more. As good a shooter as he is from out there.
Well, he is a freshman and maybe he'll a little tentative at times. Made a nice pass that time to Jasper. Missed the reverse, but drew the foul and will be at the line when we return. 52-40.
No, I'm not going to go through it line by line, but have you ever actually looked at this thing? I mean, account research fee, $32. Deposit verification, $12. Are these even actual terms? It's like someone spent their entire day thinking of ways to nickel and dime us.
Everything's getting faster, sexier, and yet less expensive. So, why not cars? Say hello to the G6 sedan, G6 coupe, and G6 hardtop convertible. G6, one of the fastest growing brands in America. Pontiac, designed for action.
For our fuel comes from oil in the ground. A lot of it comes from our people, who year in and year out put so much of their energy into everything they do. So you can be sure that when you put Valero gas into your tank, you're going to get a lot out of it. Valero, the energy to take you anywhere.
And a reminder to those of you watching on FSN South and Sun Sports, immediately following this game will be Mississippi State and Florida. And as we said, road wins hard to come by even for the top-ranked Gators. And I think Mississippi State's only lost once at home this season.
Maybe some encouragement coming to Mississippi State after witnessing what Ole Miss really put a little bit of fear, I think, into the Gators in Gainesville on Saturday.
Florida, Mississippi State coming up next on FSN South and Sun Sports. Kentucky by 12. The Wildcats have only two field goals in the second half. Two threes on 2 of 8 shooting. Georgia's 4 of 10, 40%. Turnovers have been the nemesis of the Bulldogs.
As it has been all year long. This is the club averaging, as I said, 17 turnovers a game.
Georgia is winning the rebounding battle. And here's Jasper. Missed the first free throw, shooting for his third point. He does have 6 assists. Back to what the margin was at halftime.
Oh, Jasper playing the point guard position on defense. He is really tough to see around. I mean, the guy's 6'6". He's got a great wingspan. Tough for those smaller guards to make passes.
Gaines found a seam. Back tap by Morris, but right to Woodbury. And then the three down by Brown. And finally, Georgia gets a field goal. Brown has double digits now, 10 points.
1-3-1 half-court trap by Georgia.
Timeout, Kentucky.
And seeing that, Tubby Smith calls a timeout. So Georgia gets the throwdown, and then they go to the zone defense, and Kentucky takes a timeout. Teams discuss strategy. You should, too. Get someone to talk with you, not at you. Talk to Chuck, Charles Schwab.
You know, Tom, at this point in the season, what you start to see are clubs who have watched a lot of tape of the teams that they're playing, particularly in conference play. And immediately when Tubby Smith saw that 1-3-1 half-court trap, that was probably something he anticipated, but he needed to talk to his club about the way he wanted to align them. Pretty nice play right here, I thought, by Woodbury to grab this ball and make that interior pass to Brown. Surprised he got that shot off the way Kentucky's been rejecting shots tonight.
Brown waiting for Stevenson, the shot blocker, to sail by before he slammed it home. There's Tubby Smith, as we said, who spent some time in Georgia bench here in Athens.
Immediately, Georgia goes back to man-to-man.
Meeks missed, but off the Bulldog. Tom Hammond, Larry Conley in Athens, Georgia, the Stegman Coliseum. Matchup between SEC East foes. Kentucky led by as many as 17 in the first half, 13 at intermission, despite the fact that Randolph Morris, who's battling inside there, picked up three first half fouls. Then Georgia started the second half with an 8-0 run. And Gaines takes it to the rim and draws the foul. But when Randolph Morris, who didn't start the second half, came in, Kentucky immediately went on a 10-4 run to reassume command of the game. First foul on Porter of Kentucky. And Gaines will have another. Dr. Pepper scoreboard.
No surprise there. South Carolina leading Arkansas at halftime.
That is a surprise.
Yes.
Ole Miss up on Tennessee playing without Chris Lofton.
Look at that score.
Vanderbilt, they're hot as can be, aren't they?
23-8 over LSU in Baton Rouge.
Well, they've taken, what, 4 of 5 against ranked teams this season and trying to add another notch in their belt.
How about that? At the beginning of the season, no one was talking about Vanderbilt. Still a long way to go down there, though.
Dennis Felton with some applause for that and a big smile for the ball boy who was out at center court doing a little housekeeping before Kentucky brings it up with a 53-44 lead. Just about the midway point of the second half. Reach in, swipe. Gaines.
Like I said, you got to protect that basketball against these Georgia guards. They are one of the leading steal teams in this conference. They average almost 10 per game.
10 minutes to go. They're back within 7, the Dogs. And the crowd again trying to rally the Georgia Dogs. Crawford with a spin short. Crawford, after 17 in the first half, has not scored in the second. Woodbury's three is good. Now they say a foot on the line, a long range two.
Now they've got the crowd in it again.
Again, they've cut the lead to 5. Gaines. And then Bliss decks Porter. It'll be Georgia's ball.
Watch Sunday out of Gaines. Michael Porter never knew what hit him. He is so quick with those hands. And then Woodbury with that foot just on the line. Got the deuce, but they're back again. think there's some discussion about that two or three, Tom, that we were just talking about. You said it was five. It was five, but they had four on the scoreboard up there.
They'd counted it a three, but I think Rick Crawford had indicated a 2 foot on the line, so the score correct now. 5-point game.
They should come over and ask you every time.
No, I don't think so.
Here's Brown, low post, attacking Randolph Morris. Thomas comes to double, put it up anywhere, and scored. How in the world?
I don't think he got off the floor. I think he just turned around and put it up on the glass, and it went in.
The lead is three. Jasper's in trouble. Nobody comes to the ball, has to call a timeout. He calls a 30.
I will never understand why, when a teammate is in trouble like that, why a player doesn't go to his aid. You got to go help a guy that's in trouble and can't get rid of the ball. He's used up his dribble. Let's go back and look at Takeus Brown against this double team underneath. Tom, I'm with you. I don't know how he got this shot off. He's got Morris on one side. Here comes the help from the other side. He just turned around, just threw it up there. It was an amazing shot. He had Thomas on one side and Morris on the other.
The lead cut to three. It was as many as 17 in the first half. Sort of like the Alabama-Georgia game in reverse. It was Georgia that had the big lead before Alabama came back on them. Turnovers all even at 10 apiece now. The difference is Georgia's gotten 16 points off the Kentucky turnovers. The Wildcats only 12. A 10-0 run, and Gaines has keyed it for the Bulldogs. Kentucky still only 2 field goals in the second half on 2 of 11 shooting. They're both threes. And Crawford, who had 17 in the first half, has not scored. Bradley, fall away. Jasper tapped it to himself but couldn't save it. Georgia ball.
And all of a sudden, that well-oiled machine that flowed so well in the first half has just disappeared here in the second half. Kentucky has not been able to get their offense rolling the way they did in that first 20 minutes.
Georgia's hitting 8 of 15 in the second half, 53%. Kentucky 2 of 11, that's 18% shooting. Mercer. Tough catch right in traffic by Brown, who missed that jump hook. Got it back for a moment. Loose ball claimed by Crawford. Jasper gets it to Bradley to lay it in.
I wasn't sure at midcourt who was going to come up with that basketball. Good pass by again by Jasper. What is that, 7 assists for him now, isn't it?
It is indeed. First basket for Bradley. Kentucky's third field goal of the half. Gaines nearly lost it, did lose it. But Brown saves for Georgia. Thomas has him trapped in the corner. Now Newman. They left him wide open. Took it to the rim. Couldn't score. Loose ball. Mercer. Gaines retreats behind the three-point line and hits. Into Morris against Brown. Here comes the help. Newman slapped it away. Morris got it back. Couldn't hit. Woodbury has it. Georgia can tie or take the lead.
How about this comeback? I mean, it's the second comeback in the second half.
I don't know what that was. Not a good looking shot, but Brown cut off baseline and trapped right there. Loose ball. Last touch by Bradley of Kentucky. Sundiata Gaines with 7 points in this second half, leading the Georgia comeback.
If you're looking to ramp up your ride, get ready. Advance Auto Parts has a special order center just for you. Your one-of-a-kind, one-stop shop for everything you could ever want in parts and performance accessories. Everything from lift kits to cool custom accessories is ready for direct-to-your-door delivery or convenient in-store pickup. When you want the most complete selection of parts and accessories, the only place to go is the Special Order Center in Advance Auto Parts. We're ready in advance.
Many half-ton trailer hitches on the road look like this. Here's the one you want. That's the biggest toad in the puddle. Available on the all-new full-size Tundra. Learn more at Toyota.com. What makes a work truck beautiful? Guts. Available on the all-new full-size Tundra. Learn more at Toyota.com.
Our hometown.
By the way, I heard about that wreck the other day.
Yeah, it happened right out there. You know, your world can change in an instant if you're not prepared. I'm just glad help arrived quickly and everyone's okay.
Man, I can't believe that happened to your family.
Oh, well, in a way they are my family. I'm their Farm Bureau insurance agent.
Helping you is what we do best.
Field goal shooting. Kentucky only 21% of the second in half. Bulldogs 47%. A turnaround from the numbers in the first half, as you see. 6:25. Georgia has the ball with 9 to shoot. The last Georgia lead was 10-9 with 13:49 to go in the opening half. Humphrey off a screen, gets the inbound pass. Shot clock at 6. 3 to shoot.
Wonder if they know it.
Gaines with 2 to shoot. A 3-pointer, no good. And Jasper has the rebound. His pass deflected and taken by Newman. Here's Mercer against Perry. And rebounded by Perry, who hung in there.
Boy, Mercer would love to have that one back.
Perry for 3. The senior can't hit, and Humphrey high for the rebound. Lob for Gaines. And 1.
Watch Orbsud come in late here. Gaines with a catch. Instead of fouling him, he just grabbed him. Probably tried to keep him from hurting him, but why didn't he try to block the shot? That's what I want to know.
You're going to foul him, don't let him score.
Absolutely.
Now he has a chance for a 3-point play, and Gaines with 12 points, 9 of them in this second half.
He's the leader of this basketball team. You want to pick one guy out and say night after night, you're going to get a consistent performance. It's going to be Sunday out of Gaines.
Orbshoot will go out, and Stevenson replaces him. Joe Crawford back in for Kentucky, yet to score in the second half after 17 in the first. Rimmed up in the corner. Bliss saves to Humphrey. What a hustle play by Dave Bliss. Brown inside over Perry. Good.
It was a long climb up that mountain, but they've got the lead now.
Their last lead at 10-9 with 13:49 in the first half until now. They trailed by as many as 17. Lob for Morris. In traffic, got it.
Great catch in there by Morris. Boy, he was battling, I mean, a couple of guys down in there to make that catch. Good feed in there, too, on the part of Bobby Perry.
He has 10 points. Brown with 10 points in the second half. Gaines with 9, keying the comeback. Bliss lost it, but last touch by Kentucky.
Watch this nice maneuver right here. A good catch by Brown. He got a little bit of a bump, too, as he went up for that shot. Good acquisition by the Bulldogs. Dennis Felton, as I said in the first half, the recognition that he needed some strength and power in there, and he got a good one in Takeus Brown.
Impressive comeback for the Georgia Bulldogs. Newman finds Woodbury. Pull-up shot good by Terrence Woodbury.
Had Bradley on him. That's about a 6-inch advantage. A good stop. A runner from the left. Boy, Georgia's offense looks so much better in the second half.
4.5 minutes to play. This is more like the game we expected from the outset. Here's Meeks, three-pointer, badly looking off the rim. Bad miss by Meeks, and Georgia has it back. Tubby not happy. Check those Dr. Pepper scores as they go by.
Texas Tech up on Texas A&M.
Here's Gaines getting away and feeding Brown for another slam from Gaines.
How many times tonight has Georgia been able to find Takeus Brown down on that block
and how many,
in that lane?
And how many times has it been Gaines that gets him the ball? Perry with a drive. Shoots over Brown, short. Strong rebound by Crawford, who will go to the line looking for his first points of the half. Joe Crawford will be at the Kentucky line when we return with 3:52 to play. 61-57 back after this from your local SEC station.
Each note comes alive as though it were performed live. This is the experience of the Infinity Studio on Wheels, inside the all-new Infinity G. Sound beyond machine.
Here at Safe Auto, we realize not everyone likes our beloved jingle. Some find it, well, too infectious. So putting customer service first, I personally decided to cease and desist. Oh, excuse me. Uh-huh. I'm what? Hey! Wait, hey!
Management feels that those who don't love our jingle maybe just haven't heard it enough, so enjoy!
Everybody has that one friend.
Ended up losing my apartment.
Who never quite grew up.
You're gonna come home, you're gonna stay with us.
Now.
Dupree, live with us?
Dupree is making himself right at home.
That's not good.
No.
You, me, and Dupree.
Bye!
Now playing on pay-per-view. Stay tuned after the credits for hilarious alternate ending.
What happened in there? It was so natural, so...
Get it now on in-demand pay-per-view.
This week at 11 Eastern.
The Altel SEC Game of the Week has been brought to you by Altel. By Toyota. By Sonic Drive-In. And by Advance Auto Parts.
Donna Smith knows her way around Athens, but not too pleased with the turn of events here in the second half. Donna, of course, spent time as the first lady of Georgia basketball, and her son Gigi, of course, played here as well. Tonight's telecast featuring Georgia brought to you in part by the Georgia Farm Bureau. 61-57 at the 3:52 mark. Kentucky with Tubby Smith, 2-0 on the road in SEC play. This season, they've beaten Georgia five straight times. But Dennis Felton and the Bulldogs with a tremendous comeback here in the second half.
I'll tell you what, it hadn't just been one guy, but if you had to focus on one guy, Takeus Brown has been that man.
And Sunday out of Gaines. In fact, Gaines with 9 points in the half and some nice assists, and Brown with 12 in the half. Speaking of the half, that was Crawford's first point of the second half after those 17 gaudy numbers in the first. Second one no good, and Woodbury the rebound. Gaines penetrates, scores!
Boy, he laid that right shoulder on Crawford and just worked him away from that basket enough to get that shot up.
11 and a half for Gaines. Skip pass. Crawford, open shot. Got the roll off the front of the rim. His first field goal in the second half. He now has 20 for the game.
They made a switch. Bradley now guarding Gaines. Now Morris has got him.
Picked him up on the switch. Randolph Morris. So lob inside to Brown. Used his body to screen the defenders and put it through.
Smart play by Brown.
Morris trying to get the edge. High kick. Crawford got it down.
How about that bounce?
Wow, you talk about a soft touch. Three, the charm. That makes it a two-point game. 23 points for Joe Crawford. Georgia's hit six in a row. Gaines back out. Woodbury, three, no good. And Meeks the rebound for Kentucky.
He's got numbers.
Cats on the run. Meeks throwing reverse to Crawford, and suddenly Joe Crawford's come alive again.
He was in hibernation for most of the second half. He has come out of the cave.
I believe he scored eight in a row.
Yes.
2 minutes left. Here's Gaines. Gave it up to Woodbury, takes it back. Shot clock at six. Fans counting it down. Two to shoot. Gaines, I don't think he knew it. Mercer got it away and missed it. And then Brown the rebound, but stepped out of bounds.
Dennis Velden is complaining that Morris pushed him out of bounds.
Again, Larry.
Watch it again. Late shot right there. Now watch Morris, 33. Hard to tell from that angle.
Kentucky with the ball in a tie game. Newman deflected on the entry pass to Morris. Georgia gets it right back. Timeout Bulldogs. I didn't think Randolph Morris very aggressively went after that pass, just letting Newman get around him to deflect it. And the steal for the Bulldogs.
Well, one of the things they teach you in college basketball and also at the NBA level is to really aggressively get yourself set to receive that ball. That time Morris, you're right, Tom. He did get himself a good position to really go after.
Clock shows a minute 13. It'll be Georgia's basketball. A reminder to those of you watching on FSN South and Sun Sports. Coming up next will be Florida, Mississippi State. Four ties, six lead changes in this game with a minute 13 left and the score knotted at 65. See the reset. And here's Gaines. He'll be guarded by Bradley as he comes across the timeline. Mercer. Crawford has him. Now picked up by Morris, who quickly hustles back to Newman. Newman tried to feed it backwards and lost it. Meeks.
Oh, bad pass by Meeks. That was one of those balls you need to dribble as far as you can take it and wait for your teammates to fill those lanes.
Gaines picked up by Morris on the switch, and Morris fouled him. That'll be the fourth on Randolph Morris, who picked up three of those in the first half.
Mercer with the basketball, working on that Newman screen out front. When Newman tries to go down inside, a bad pass, but a good steal by Meeks. Not the pass he wants to make in that position right there. particularly when you got one of the best guys that's stealing the basketball, Sunday out of Gaines in front of you.
Gaines with 14, now still 14 points. Bliss comes in for Georgia, replacing Brown. Morris has four fouls for Kentucky. Georgia has Gaines, Stoops, and Mercer all with three. 11 of the points by Sundiata Gaines have come in this second half.
Sexton Paul also got good,
but he got the rebound off the further end. He knew where it was going. So short on the second one, but he gets the rebound, and now we're down under 30 seconds to play. Timeout, Georgia. It's a 30. 26.3 seconds with 25 on the shot clock. So Dennis Felton telling his players, I'm sure, whatever you do, don't shoot too early. We'll either win it or go to overtime.
Great opportunity for the Bulldogs right here. They've come back on the back of two guys in the second half, Takaeus Brown and Sundiata Gaines. You would expect they would be the two guys that you would really want to handle the basketball. Gaines will get it. I would think he would look for Brown as much as he can down inside, but Kentucky's defense has really got to rise up now.
One timeout left each way. Kentucky has committed seven fouls, Georgia six. You see the game clock on the right, 26.3 seconds, and on top, the 25 seconds is the shot clock. Bradley's going to get right up on Gaines as Woodbury will trigger it inbounds. Now, Coach Felton says, no, let's switch that. Let's have Mercer throw it in.
Is everybody organized? I think we're ready to go.
Tony Green says play ball. Gaines against Bradley. Now Newman. Thomas comes out on him. Shot clock at 12. Newman needs help. Gaines gives it to him. Seven to shoot. Five to shoot. Gaines gets a screen. Two to shoot. Sundiata Gaines, a prayer. And that'll be a shot clock violation. It did not hit the rim. Game clock shows 0.8 seconds. 0.8.
Enough time to get off a legal shot.
And Tubby Smith will take a 30 to discuss. Getting off the shot with 0.8 seconds remaining. That was not a good possession by Georgia. They didn't run anything. They just Gaines was up against the shot clock and had to just heave it toward the basket.
I got to tell you, I got to credit Kentucky's defense on that particular play because they really pressured the ball and they forced Gaines out of way. And I'll give Bradley credit for that. When the screen was set out front, Morris came out and challenged him and made it more difficult for him to get the shot, knowing that the shot clock had gotten down under 5 seconds. Good defensive work, I thought, by the Kentucky team that time.
Yeah, Ramel Bradley, even before the ball was pitched inbounds, was right up in the jaw of Sundiata Gaines.
Watch it again here. Newman with the ball. Now look at this. Bradley was trying to stay with Gaines. Here comes the screen by Brown. Now watch Morris step out here. See, that helped. Made it difficult for him to get that shot off. A good defensive play and good help that time by Randolph Morris.
Again, Kentucky had led by 17 in the first half, by 13 at intermission. Georgia came back to open the second half, got within five, saw Kentucky go up again by about a dozen, and then once again Georgia cut it to five, and then from that point on, it's been nip and tuck back and forth. The Bulldogs getting the lead, the Wildcats getting the lead back. Here we come down to the final 0.8 seconds, and Kentucky has used its final timeout. And looks like Tony Green is examining the replay, probably a timing issue.
Yeah, the shot clock, they want to know what time the shot clock expired and at what point on the game clock they need to stop that clock. I think they're going to leave it with 0.8 seconds.
Donna Smith can barely watch.
as can approximately 3 million Kentuckians probably tonight watching.
Four ties, six lead changes. Kentucky led by 17. Georgia's biggest lead early was four, and then again late for the Bulldogs. They had a four-point edge here in the second half. Well, we gave Kentucky credit for that sticky defense on the inbounds play. Let's see what Georgia does here with only 0.8 seconds on the clock.
It's got to be heave all the way to the top of the circle or the free throw line.
Thomas throws it right into Mercer, who launches one from back court, which did hit the backboard. But we're going to overtime. Who would have guessed this when Kentucky was waltzing along in the first half? Joe Crawford scoring at will, and the Wildcats up 17. Well, we've got OT in Athens. Georgia and Kentucky, first overtime coming up.
The dream is still alive. Someday it will come true. And this country, it belongs to folks like me and you. So let the voice of freedom sing out through this land. This is our country.
This is our truck. The 2007 Motor Trend Truck of the Year. The all-new Chevy Silverado.
You called our insurance agent.
Uh-huh.
When's he coming?
I don't know.
Well, what'd he say?
I left a message.
When was that? We don't have Farm Bureau, do we?
No.
Heading to overtime in Athens, those of you waiting to see Florida Mississippi State on FSN South and Sun Sports, it'll be coming up at the conclusion of this game. Kentucky in that second half, Larry, just hitting 7 of 21 shots, while Georgia was 15 of 29 in the second half.
It was a complete reversal. Maybe a little play on Diggins here, but it was a tale of two halves, both of them totally different.
The best of times, the worst of times.
It was for each club.
A lot of Kentucky blue in the house as usual. The Wildcat fans always travel to support their team. But the predominantly red-clad fans here in the Stegman Coliseum appreciate the comeback by their Bulldogs to send it into overtime. And Kentucky, remember, has Randolph Morris playing with four fouls. He'll jump it up against Bliss to start the overtime period. Bliss back taps to Gaines. Gaines, Brown, Mercer, Bliss, and Woodbury for Georgia. Jasper, Bradley, Morris, Thomas, and Crawford, Kentucky.
Man-to-man defense by Kentucky to start this overtime period.
Bliss, low block, double team, stolen by Crawford. Crawford racing Gaines to the hoop to lay it in.
Well, all of a sudden, Joe Crawford has just reappeared, hadn't he? Great first half, disappeared for about 12 to 13 minutes of the second half, and now has surged.
A career high 27 points for Joe Crawford.
Crawford trying to keep Mercer at bay.
Woodbury picked up by Bradley, lost it to Jasper for a moment. Gaines got it back, eight to shoot. Five to shoot. Gaines picked up by Morris, nowhere to go with it. Got it, Brown, and scored! Cindy out of Gaines, heads up, and Brown got the basket.
His favorite target of the night. Cindy out of Gaines has just driven Kentucky crazy getting into that lane and finding a wide open Takaeus Brown most of the time.
16 points in the second half for Brown, 18 in the game. Ten to shoot. Morris sets a screen for Crawford. Lets it fly short. Nabbed by Woodbury, and Georgia a chance to take the lead.
Good screen by Bliss.
When he sets one, you know it. Three minutes left in OT. Here's Bliss attacking Morris, who has the four fouls. Mercer penetrates, dishes Woodbury, three, good!
Well, Woodbury has made some timely threes for the Bulldogs tonight. None of them more important than that one.
Here's Bradley, got a step, snapped away by Mercer on the floor. Kentucky's Thomas calls it. Well, one official called a timeout, and then they say another called a held ball, but the timeout is granted. Thomas gets the timeout. One official had signaled held ball, but the timeout is granted. It's Kentucky's final in this overtime period. 70-67, Georgia has the lead.
So we had this sudden panic. We've got investments all over. You name it, we've invested in it. What does it all add up to? I mean, realizing after, what, 25 years, that you don't even know what your investment picture actually looks like. That's a midlife crisis.
There are five ways to satisfy a jumbo shrimp craving, and only one place to do it. It's Jumbo Shrimp at Red Lobster, starting at $11.99. Choose your irresistible favorite, like hand-breaded jumbo crunch fried or mouth-watering jumbo scampi. Or try new Mediterranean jumbo shrimp pasta. Tender shrimp tossed in Italian herb butter with artichokes, fresh tomatoes, and sautéed onions. It's Jumbo Shrimp for a limited time, only at Red Lobster.
Watch Terrence Woodbury get this ball on the wing. Nice pass again by Mike Mercer. Woodbury nails a three. They've had a number of guys shoot threes very well this year. You can see their numbers. They got five right there. Woodbury, Humphrey, Newman, Stoops, and Gaines, all of them excellent three-point shooters. Tonight hasn't been so good except for Woodbury.
Interesting that Georgia's been able to mount the comeback without their leading scorer Mercer and without Levi Stoops. Essentially, they have only 9 points between the two of them, none in the second half or overtime. In fact, Stoops hasn't played that much of the second half. It's been Sunday out of games, and Takeus Brown that carried the offense for the Bulldogs. Jasper looking to pitch it in to Crawford. Stoops has in. Crawford spins on him, pulls up, shot good. Pretty move by Joe Crawford.
I'll tell you what, Levi Stoops couldn't have done any more defensively than what he did to Crawford. He was still able to get it up and get it in. That was a terrific move. What a last 8 minutes that Crawford has played.
Continues to add to his career high, now 29 points. Deeps. Staying with Mercer. Here's Bliss with a bullet pass to Stoops. Brown surrounded as Crawford came to help out Thomas. Now Gaines with three to shoot. Two to shoot. Three-pointer, Gaines.
Banked it in! Oh, my goodness!
Including the three-point bank with the shot clock expiring for Sunday out of games. What else can he do?
It was just desperation. I mean, he had to get rid of the ball. The shot clock was going down. He even kicked his legs underneath of him to get it up, to get the strength to get it up.
14 of the second half for games, 17 in the contest. Wow. So with a minute 32, the lead is 4. Kentucky will get it back as Bradley returns. Jasper goes out. Meeks lobs, bad pass. Deflected out of bounds by Bliss. He had Perry wide open back at midcourt. Five on the shot clock. Lost. Out of bounds. Last touch by Sunday out of games. Tubby Smith went down.
How about the defensive pressure by Georgia on this out-of-bounds play by Kentucky? That's twice now. They've been unable to get it in.
Crawford gets it in easily to Perry that time. And they set it up. Through the hands of Crawford. Unforced turnover. And Georgia has it with a four-point lead. 14th turnover of the game.
Tom, you're always taught at a very young age to look the ball into your hands. Watch Crawford right there. Took his eye off of it, went right off of his outside hand out of bounds, and the Bulldogs with a good golden opportunity.
They'll work on that clock now, which shows a minute 12. Final minute of overtime. 10 to shoot. 6 to shoot. This is what Gaines wants to see. There he is. Almost, but he'll go to the free throw line. How many miracle shots can he make with the shot clock going down? And it looks like Randolph Morris has just fouled out of the game.
He has indeed. How about the play of Sundiata Gaines in this second half? Terrific move inside. We've got to give Gaines credit. He and Brown have really carried this Georgia club the second half.
And Morris will foul out with 11 points and only 2 rebounds. Picked up his 3rd foul in the first half. Was a little surprised that Tubby left him in the game at that point. Picked up his 3rd. He had 2, and normally that makes you take a trip to the bench, but he stayed on the court. He went out of the first half with 4:28 on the clock with 6 points and his 3rd foul. And here's the hero of the moment, Sundiata Gaines.
Well, he really struggles at the free throw line, doesn't he? Came into this game a 61% free throw shooter, has missed his last 3 in a row.
Missed them both. Here's Crawford in a hurry. Perry for 3. Offensive rebound.
I think Bliss is going to get the foul.
That was Jasper with the offensive rebound and got a finger in the eye. First foul on Bliss. It puts Derek Jasper at the free throw line, where he's only a 56% free throw shooter. 36 seconds left in overtime. 3 points, 6 assists for Jasper tonight. No good. Rebounded by Woodbury, and they foul him immediately.
Woodbury a little bit better free throw shooter.
69% on the season. It's his first trip to the line tonight. He does have 15 points. It's the first 5-point lead. And Kentucky, which had won 11 straight, in danger now of losing their 2nd in a row. This will be a huge comeback win for the Georgia Bulldogs.
After being down by 17.
Second one no good. Rebound on the floor, picked up by Newman as Perry and Jasper knocked it away from each other, and then a foul. So they fumble away the rebound, and Meeks commits the foul.
Tom, it's been that kind of second half and overtime for Kentucky tonight. Give Georgia credit. They have been very opportunistic. Scored when they had to, and they've gotten it on 2 guys and everybody else making strong contributions.
Gaines finally makes a free throw.
Let's take a look at this free throw right here. You see the miss. Nothing but Kentucky players battling, and they're battling each other.
That time Gaines makes sure he hits both free throws. Crawford, three-pointer, no good. Newman the rebound. Here's the outlet pass. They don't need any more points, but Mercer couldn't resist. Woodbury gives it back to Mercer. This time he gets it.
What a comeback by Georgia.
Crawford, a three-pointer, no good. Final seconds. And Georgia has done it. They break a five-game losing streak to Kentucky, hand the Wildcats their second straight loss, and do it in fine fashion with an amazing comeback, trailing by as many as 17 in the first half. Our Red Lobster nothing but net shot of the game. The score tied at 55 and the lob to Gaines, who gives Georgia the lead, and fouled by Orbzoot. So a tremendous comeback for the Georgia Bulldogs, who go to 12-6, 4-2 in the conference. Kentucky drops to 4-2 in the SEC, 15-5 overall. Tremendous game in Athens tonight, especially if you're a Bulldog fan. Tom Hammond for Larry Conley saying so long from Athens. You've been watching Lincoln Financial Sports SEC basketball coverage.
This week on FSN's Pro Football Preview, our Super Bowl bets tell you what's really going on behind the scenes as the Colts and Bears get ready for the big game. Friday on FSN.
Defense